So before we start, I just wanted to ask you, we needed your help over Yom Tov. So yesterday we learned that when a rabbi walks with his sidekicks, so the on his right side should be the greater of the two sidekicks, and on his left side should be the weaker of the two sidekicks. And the Gemara took as a marshal, the Gemara picked that when they came to visit, when the Malachim came to visit Avram, when they came to, Avigdor, is my sound still bad? Or is it better?
Still bad.
Still bad. It's going on, but it doesn't sound clear at all.
Okay, so
one second. Maybe,
let me see if I'm using the wrong one.
Oh, that's what it was. I'm using the power conference. Let me see.
That's better. Yeah, that bothered me also, but what specifically bothered you?
So, how do you, who made up the pecking order for the Malachim?
In the Malachim, right.
I thought you could give us some insight why Machal is number one, why Gavriel is number two, and why Rafal is number three.
Right. So that bothered me also, but
I can't hear you what you're saying. Let me try it again. Speaker. Let me test my speakers. Okay, now I hear you.
Okay, so, you know, they should take this to the Malachim Rights Tribunal and come, you know, file their complaints, because I don't see why one Malach should be more chashuv than the next. Turns out, though, that the Malach HaMavis, or the Satan, or the Yetzirah, or whatever you want to call him, seems to have the most chashuv position in Shemaim. The Rosh Shalom has private conversations with him. So I don't know. I don't get it.
Hansi suggested yesterday that in that particular visit, Machol was the first one, because he was delivering the news to Avram they would have a child. Gavriel had the second job to turn over Sidayim. And Rafal had the third job to heal Avram. So the Cheshivas was an order of whose job came first.
Right, but jobs change, right? There's a chazal.
Maybe their pecking order changed too, depending on their mission. And just in that mission, Machol was number one.
Maybe you remember when who was it? Yaakov asked the Malach, "What's your name?" Right. Depends on the job. It depends on the function of the Malach. So his name keeps changing. So that's also another mystery. So I don't know. I'm sorry. I can't help you there. I have no insights on it.
Okay. Thank you. I think there's my mic so bad.
Yeah. It was good for a minute and then it went bad again. There's something. Something's not right. Sounds very.
Okay, because I'm using the power conference, so what I'll do is I'll go back to the one inside the unit, inside the computer.
Okay, how's it now? Really? So the power conference is not as good as the. Okay, so we're good now. So let's see the Gemara. Ve'elu lignai. We're up to the Mishnah on Daf Lamed Ches Amud Aleph, and it's the third wide line, and we learned about a whole bunch of people who made nice donations to the Beis HaMikdash, and the Mishnah said those are remembered l'shvach. And now the Mishnah says ve'edel l'gnai. The following are remembered l'gnai. This is a Gemara will be very familiar because we learned about it very recently. Ve'edel l'gnai. The Chofetz Chaim asks, since when do we speak lashon hara, that we list off people doing gnai? What makes the kasha even more difficult is the list of people who are mentioned aren't even balei aveira. They just did things that Chazal were not happy about, but there's no affair that they did. So the Chofetz Chaim says that when someone's acting inappropriately, continue, if he acts occasionally inappropriately, you're not allowed to speak lashon hara about someone who doesn't affair. But if they're continuing to do it with determination, then you're supposed to publicize them. I guess that's why they publicize the get refusers. Okay, so let's see what it says. It's a style now, I think, that they out them on social media. So Zakti Gemara, Ve'el Lignai. The following are remembered of Nai. Shall base Garmu, the base Garmu family, the Rotul Lamid al Maisa Lechem upon them. They knew how to make the Lechem upon them, and they refused to share the secret. Shall base Haftinas, Loi Rotu, Lamid al Maisa Ktaris. They knew how to make the Ktaris, and they didn't want to share the secret. Hugris bin Levi, Hoyadea Perik Bashir, he had a certain technique of how to adjust the tone of his voice, the Loi Rotul Lamid, and he didn't want to teach it. It doesn't mean like a guy like Helfgott didn't want to teach us how to sing, because you know he can't transfer DNA. But we're talking about a technique-based thing. And then Kamtzer Lirata Lamed Al Maisek Sav. He was able to write with four fingers simultaneously, so he could strap a pen onto each of his four fingers and then simultaneously write four different letters, such as we'll see soon Yud Kei Vav Kei. Al Rishonim Nemar, on the people in the earlier Mishnah who did good things, it says Zecher Tzadik Levracha. Al Eilu Nemar, and on these, the Pasuk says, V'shem Rishonim Yirkov, the name of the Rishonim, should rot out. So there's a shaila. If you own a trade secret, for instance, you know Coca-Cola's recipe, are you allowed, if you're Muchav to share, is Coca-Cola Muchuyev to share its recipe? Why is it that these people, these families, we're mechuyev to share a recipe? So the poskim can speak about it. And they said, if you have like a life-saving secret, such as the cure to cancer, then you're mechuyev to share it. But if you just have a trade secret that makes you do something that others can do, but you can do it better, of course, you're not mechuyev to share a trade secret. Here the issue was, there was something that they could have shared that would be mekadesh shem shamayim. And that's why it was expected of them to be able to share it. Morning. So Zok the Helig Gemara. Tanya Rabbanan. Beis Garmi, how you became the Maaseh Lechem upon them. They knew how to make Lechem upon them. They wrote to the Lamed, but they didn't want to share that secret. So Shalchu Chachamim, the Chachamim sent out. They view Umnin me Alexandria Shal Mitzrayim. They found experts who lived in Mitzrayim. How you yoidin lefes kamoishim. They knew how to make the Lechem upon them, but how you yoidin lerados kamoishim. They didn't know how to extract the Lechem upon them from the oven the way base Garmi knew, in such a way where it wouldn't damage the bread. These people from Alexandria had to heat the oven up on the outside and bake on the outside. They didn't put the bread into the oven because they wouldn't have been able to get it out without damaging it. But Valolu, the base Garmi, they were able to bake it inside, which would dry it out better. And you know, if something has less moisture in it, it's less likely to spoil. Halalu pitnu misapeshes. These people, their technique, it could cause the bread to get spoiled. Halalu ain't pitnu misapeshes. And the Shadim asks, wasn't there not a nace that the bread, the lechem upon was fresh the day they took it off, just like it was freshly baked? And on that of the Gemara, mikol makay masha efshir bidei adam, and he touches the Shadim answers, mikol makay masha efshir bidei adam, lahoy HaKadosh Baruch Hu roitz losaki. The nace is what's necessary, but what could be done to avoid any problems must be done. So Kishashamu Chachamim Medaber, and the Chacham heard that their replacement people weren't producing the lechem upon them up to par. Amru, they said, Kol Masha Bara Kadosh Baruch Hu L'Chvayde Bara. Any thing that the Rebbe Hashem created, even a talent, a technique, a method, is L'Chvayde. And therefore, because it says in the Pasuk, Shnemer Kol Nikar B'Shmi Hu L'Chvayde Barasif. So therefore, Yachzru beiskar mulum koyman. If there is such a technique that would allow the bread, the lechem upon, to be baked properly, we have to use it. We can't not use it, which means we can't settle for the inferior lechem upon baked by those people from Alexandria. We have to get the beiskar mulum back. We got to get the exclusives back. Shalchu lam chacham. The chacham sent to them. V'leibo, they didn't want to come. Now you want us? No, now we're not coming. So kaflu lehem soran. So they gave them double what they were getting paid until now. Ubo, oh, they came back. Every day it took 12 mana. Now we were discussing 2 mana is approximately $30,000 to $40,000. So 12 mana per day is about $120,000 a day. So it's very interesting how much money we're talking about. That's a lot of money. Rabbi Yudaimer even worse. Because two mana, Masayim, is the Shir Ksuba. The Shir Ksuba that a woman is given is about $35,000-$40,000.
Yeah, that's more than my lawyer asks for per hour.
You know, you remind me of a story about this plumber who was called out in the middle of the night to solve. When he came, he charged $500. So the guy says, $500 an hour? My doctor doesn't even charge that much. So the plumber says, yeah, when I used to practice medicine, neither did I.
Is this a daily fee? Like, why do you need them every day? You just need them to make the bread once a week.
Once a week. Yeah, that's a good point. That's a good point. Yeah, thank you.
No, not that much. That's much better, but...
Unless they purposely dragged it out, so every day they bake one bread or something. There are unions, you know? Like the workers on the street. It takes like a team of workers like 4 days to fix a small pothole on Bakecrest. It took the whole Shavuos to fix a small pothole on Bakecrest, but that's poshut because they needed to entertain the kids all 3 days. They didn't wake up their parents. Right. They had the whole neighborhood kids was watching them. That's what you're saying?
The Rashba says it's an annual fee.
Uh-huh. But it says b'chol yoyim. The Gemara says b'chol yoyim are united.
I know, but so the no 24 says the Rashba says that it was an annual fee.
Okay.
And that the Brisa means that in previous days they would earn 12 mana a year. Uh-huh. Days here doesn't means like once upon a time.
You just impoverished his family with one fell swoop. What's that?
I think a more accurate way of figuring out how much a mana is worth is if you see how much dinarim a mana is and how much gold is in one particular dinar, and then you see the price of gold.
Uh-huh.
That's a more accurate way. I don't even think that's an accurate way. Uh-huh. I think it's a more accurate
way. But regardless, it's a lot of money. So the Mepharshim ask, I don't understand. They didn't want to come for their regular pay. So you just double the money? Why did they bargain? Try 10% more, 5% more. The first, this is like the way the governments the negotiate the unions. Oh, you want double? Okay, we'll give you double. Like, why was there no negotiation at all? So the Mepharshim say that this whole idea was not to pay them more. It was to publicize to the world what a chashivas the lechem aponim had, and they'd be buzzed. Everyone heard how much they get paid, and that's to create a kiddushim shemaim as to how important the lechem aponim was. I think it's still shirk, but as I state, they offered them double. Okay, zok to gemara vayter, zok to gemara vayter. After they took it back, they asked them. Amar Lucham, Lucham told them, "Okay, you're working. You're back. You got your contract back. You're back in business." But Lamaisa Maru Isem Shaloi Lamed. Why are you being so stubborn, not sharing with them? Amar Lem. They answered, "Yoidim Hayu Shel Beis Abba. My family knew Shabai Yizeh that this home, the Beis Hamikdash, also Lecharet. Shel Miyomid Adam Sheinu Mahogin. What are we going to do if someone who shouldn't have this information gets this information if it's proliferated because we share it?" Imagine he makes the duplicates of lechem upon him for avoid zara. That would be terrible. But that was not accepted by the Bezdin or by the Chacham at the time. They felt it was a smokescreen and it was highly inappropriate that they didn't want to share. However, there was one good thing that they did feel about this family. He never found anybody in the Garmi family who ate white, clean bread. They shouldn't say, and there's a shot of this means using the same skill to make the lechem aponim they use to make their own bread, or maybe they're skimming off, they're siphoning off some of the flour that was given to them, that's hektish flour. They got to be squeaky clean, and therefore, they never did anything that would even allow anyone to be choishish that they were benefiting from hektish. So Beis Haftinas, they were in the Katarius business. They didn't want to teach it. It's funny, after they tried this once, they tried it again. It didn't work out for them last time, but I guess they wanted to try again. The men, people of Alexandria knew how to make Keturis, but they didn't know That'll be Malad Oshan like them. Shalalolu Mitamar Voila, Kimbako, the original made by Besatinis. The smoke went right up because of the Malad Oshan like a stick. Shalalolu Maftila Kanu Lukan. Ushashamu Chachamu Medover, when the Chachamu find out that this is how it is, Amr they said, Kol Mashabar Kadish Baruch, Uluch Vaidabar. The Kadish Baruch created the Malad Oshan, Uluch Vaidab. Shenemar Kol Paul Hashem Lamaneu. And the question is why here we use a different pasuk than there. One of the pshatim is because they're talking about what the person, the skill that a person had, the method that the person had to make lechem upon him. Here it's talking about the item, the spice called mala oshan that Hashem created for his covet. And therefore, yachsru base of tinis lamkoyim and let them go back into place. So the question that they ask is, what are you talking about? It's because it's not covet Hashem, it's kol ma shebarach tashbech l'svoidei. It says you need mala oshan. So what are you talking about? The special kiddush Hashem. It's not kosher without it. The thing that Tosfos Hashem brings down that they had mala oshan, but the mala oshan that they had didn't make it go straight up. It went a little bit differently. It didn't work so perfectly. I guess there's different types of mala oshan. So technically it was kosher at first, but it still wasn't the best way. Another shot that some Rishonim offer is that you're only mechuyev to put mala oshan in if you have it. If you don't have it, then there's no psul if you don't put it in. Shalchu lehem chachamim. Oh, in America? Oh, they do fireworks? Oh, yeah? They don't want to share the trade secret. What's their name? The Hamas family? Oh. Hamas are very big in the fireworks. Interesting. Okay, because of it's a physical climate, Shokolom Chachamim, Vulay Bo, they didn't want to come back. So once again, Kafla and Sharon, Ubo, Bhoyam, and Shema Samana, Bayoim, Eshem Varba, if you don't have Bhoyam, Eshem Varba, Bayoim, Abom Shmaim. Amun Chachamim, Mari Isam, Shalal Lamid, why are you so particular about not sharing? Amur, they said, Yoid Nayu Shabbe Saba Shabbaisa, also the Khar. Once again, Amur, they said, Shabbe Yomid Adam Shane, Mugan Vilak, Yavidavid Bachavnaka, Yaldovazem, Askinais and Lashvach, but the only thing that they are appreciated for is me'olam lo yotzas kala mevusemes mibateim. Never did anyone in their family ever wear any type of perfume. So people shouldn't be choshed that they're using the tars. U'chashenoish nisha, even more. Whenever they would marry a woman mimokamachem from another place, maslanimah, they would write it in the ksuba, shaloi tisbasim, that she's never allowed to wear perfume. Why? Shaloi yoimu mimai sakateris misbasim. L'kai mashanemar v'isam nikim eshemim yisrael. So the Mefarshim asked, how come they didn't put a tnai in the ksuba that the woman's never allowed to break white bread? They only made a tnai in the ksuba about the besamim. The teretz is, a person is not mechuyev to give his wife white bread. He could be mefarnes his wife with whole wheat bread. But there's a chiv in the ksuba for a person to give his wife tachshitin, such as perfume. So in order for him not to give her perfume, that would have to have been a tnai in the ksuba. Tanya Omer b'shmol. Pam achas yim halach v'derech. I was once strolling. And I found an enikol from the Kataris family. Amarati loy, I told this gentleman, your fathers wanted to focus the covet on themselves by keeping the recipe to the Kataris exclusive. And that, by definition, reduced covet amokim because not everybody knew how to do it, which limited the availability. Even though there's a churban loyaleinu, nevertheless, the Rabbani Shloim is still the Rabbani Shloim. But Umid Kvodim, they lost their day in the sun because they're nobody now. Nobody needs their services. Amar B'Kiva, B'Kiva said, Soch li Rabbi Shmuel ben Luga. Rabbi Shmuel ben Luga told me in a secret, Pamachas yotzasi ani v'echad v'bnei b'neihem, I and an enikol from the Beis Avtinas family, from the Avtinas family, we went into the field. We went to pick grass. Bara'isi, and I saw Shabacha v'Sachak, the gears to change it. I saw him cry, and then I saw him smile. Michael, I asked him, if they my bachas, what spontaneously triggered your tears? Amarli, kavod avoyse niskarti. I remembered the glory of the Beis Avtinas family, which is now evaporated. V'pnei Sachak, so why are you smiling? Amarli, sha'azir ha-kadosh baruch hu lachzir lanu, because I know eventually we're going to get back to our glory when Mashiach comes and rebuilds the Beis HaMikdash. So he asked him with Neiman's karta, what spontaneously triggered this reaction? Was it spontaneous? Did something trigger your reaction? Omar Lee told me Mala Osher Kenegdi. I see Mala Osher, and I see that spice. So right away, Rabbi Shmuel said, Harayuli. So which one is it? Show me. Omar Lee, he responded, Shvu Hibi Adenu. There's a Shvu in our family, Shane Myron, Isai Lachaladam, that we're not allowed to show it to anybody. Omar Rabbi Yechna Benuri, Pamachas Matsasi Zakanechad. I once met an old man, Megillah Samamana Biyada, and he had the recipe list of the Knayas. Where are you from? I'm from the Tinas family. Ani. What do you have there in your hand? So I told him, Harayuli, please show it to me. Amrili, I will show it to you. Because man shebeis abahoy kayam, as long as my family was kayam, they weren't willing to give it over to anybody. But the achshav, that there's no one left in my family who's trustworthy, the shvua that was originally in our family wasn't a permanent shvua. It was a shvua only to last as long as there were people in our family who would protect the secret. But since there isn't, then I'm going to trust you because I know you're a ish kadosh. Harei hu lach, I'll give it to you. But I ask you to continue the tradition, the zareba, but be careful that it shouldn't be proliferated, but you're trusted to carry on the tradition. And when I came, Rabbi Yechon ben Uri said, I reported to Rabbi Akiva, and I asked Rabbi Akiva, I told him, I have the secret to the Mala Oshun, to the Torahs. And Rabbi Akiva asked me, really tell me. So I asked Rabbi Akiva, can you keep a secret? He said, yes. And I said, so can I, so I won't tell you. Amar Lee, he told me, Me'ata, now that we see that it's the truth what they were saying, it's not a smokescreen. And in fact, it was only for Kavod Shemayim, and the proof is in the pudding. That when their family couldn't safeguard the secret anymore, in fact, they did share it. So, we're no longer allowed to mock them because they were talking Gans and Lashem Shemayim. Mikan Amr Ben Azai, and this is where Ben Azai got the following word from: in your name they will call you, and in your place they will seat you. Umishaloch Yitnuloch. And from yours, they will give to you. And we see from there that if something is coming to you, nobody can rip you off. Nobody can steal from you. Whatever you're supposed to have in Hashemayim, it's guaranteed you're going to get it. In Malchus, no, it happened to Rabbi Yechon ben Uri.
No, Amar Rabbi Akiva, Pam Achas Sof Li Rabbi Shmuel ben Loigo, right?
But that's not the story. It's the next story that we're on already. Rabbi Yechon Uri.
No, but remember you said that the Yekiva could keep a secret, and the guy said that so can I?
Right.
The Yekiva, the guy wasn't talking to Rabbi Yekiva.
No, I was just making up a story. After Rabbi Yechon got the list, he went to Rabbi Yekiva.
Oh.
So I assume Rabbi Yekiva probably asked him, tell me. But he didn't tell him.
Because the whole thing you said never existed.
The story that I made up? No, it's not the Gemara. It's my own narrative that I made up that never ever happened. Oh, I'm sorry. I should identify that many things that I say, you shouldn't blame on the Gemara. My Rishiva once told me you can say, oh, my Chadushim in your name, but never say your Chadushim in my name. So I'm sorry. Like I said, Gemara, Vayter, Vey Malchus, Nagas, Bechavrta. Afilu Kamal Anima. If the time has come for a king to take over, he doesn't have to worry that another king's Malchus might last too long. At the very moment that he's supposed to get what he gets, he will get it. So I'm not sure what the connection is. So either I thought pshat is just like until now, they were supposed to have the secret, now you have the secret, or the others are there, or maybe what it means is if they're supposed to have this job and they're supposed to have the money from this job, then no one else can take it away from them. I'm not sure, like, from which part of the storyline the Gemara is segueing. So I thought maybe it means is as long as they were supposed to have a secret, they'll have a secret, and any pronouns that they're supposed to have, I think they're going to have. But when the secret has to go over, it goes over, and they shouldn't worry that they're going to lose their pronouns over it because whatever is coming to them, they're going to have. That's what I thought was the hemshich. I might be wrong. Rashi doesn't say befeirs. So there's a famous story with the Sklana Rebbe. The Sklana Rebbe, when he would be invited to come to a chuppah, he would always come late. So once a Baal Simcha told him, Rebbe, Chvil is Otan, Sada condition, we want to start the chuppah on time. So the Sklana Rebbe made a point to be there on time, and there was some issue there, the chuppah was delayed for an hour. So the Rebbe said, just goes to show, it's not for me whoever delayed the chuppah. The chuppah is going to happen exactly at the precise time that it's going to happen. So sometimes I come late, but even if I would be on time, if it wasn't the right time, it's not going to happen. And there's a story, I think, with the Briskerov, he said over, that the chassan was about to take the ring out. He took the ring out, he was ready to make kedushin, and he dropped the ring. And it rolled away, and they couldn't find it. And they were looking and looking for a while, and the chassan was like stressed. He dropped the ring, and by the chuppah, he can't find it. What a crazy story. So the Briskerov says, don't worry. The Rabbi Nishlev decided the exact second that the kedushin was supposed to happen, and it didn't happen yet. Don't worry, when it's supposed to happen, you're going to find that ring. And sure enough, 15 minutes later, they found the ring, and they continued with the chuppah. And the Briskerov says, vice versa, this was the second that you were supposed to have the kedushin. Zok Gemara, Hukris Ben Levi. I think you told me a story, Hansi, about a ksuba story, a phenomenal story. What was the story? A guy did a fake, a guy had a ksuba, and the ksuba got messed up or something? Yeah, a guy had a ksuba, it was a fancy artistic ksuba, and some of them, the reshiva messed it up when he was signing it, and he freaked out. The father freaked out. There's no problem, I have another one. He pulls out this like $1.50 one that you buy in the sperm store. And the father's freaking out. Here I spent like $10,000 on a custom artist, real beautiful ksuba, he messed the whole thing up, and he was freaking out. He was going nuts right before the chuppah. So the reshiva called him to the corner and told him something, and then all of a sudden he was all happy. So they wanted to know what the reshiva told him. So the reshiva told him, you never know. It could have been a gzeir min hashamayim that your daughter should have two ksubas. So the Rebbe Shem made it, you should be yotze with these two ksubas, not through a divorce or through a loss of life. Zok Gemara, Hokus ben Levi. Tanya we learn. Kishu noisen koyle ben ima, when he would start singing, machlis goyle le soich piv. Did you ever see a chazan davening for Rabbit stick his thumb into his mouth? He would stick his thumb into his mouth, and he would put his forefinger in between his mustache hairs, and that created such a nice sound that everyone freaked out. So Rashi says that they were so taken aback by the sound, their heads went back, their heads cocked back, because like, wow. And he didn't want to share that with anybody. Once again, because that method of singing could have been used to sing to avoid his aura. However, the fourth fellow, Toner Abun ben Kamtzer, the Rata Lalamed al Maisak Saf, he didn't want to teach people how to write with four fingers simultaneously. He was able to hold four pens together at the same time. And if there was a word with four oishes, such as Yud Kevofke, what's the godless of that? Because we know it's Hashem Echad, Shmoy Echad, the name has to be written, Bechidos. So he was able to mamish write it the same kavanah because it was simultaneously being written. That was gavalt. Why did you want to teach? So kulam matzuchuvul devarim. They all had their excuse that it could be used for avoid zora, but to write the name beyichud is no mile for avoid zora because the people who are avoid zora believe in multiple gods, so they don't even need the concept of yichud. So that ability to write a name beyichud would never be needed for avoid zora. And therefore, he never had a legitimate reason why he wouldn't share that skill. Because at least they had a reason, a legitimate reason, as they proved why they concealed that information. Their name should be rotten. My v'shem yishar mirkov, my belozer rakvivos rot tala b'shmoison should grow under names, meaning you shouldn't name anybody the loy maskinim b'shmayu. You shouldn't name anybody after a rasha. Mezev Ravina, and they ask, what about Yishmol? So they say Yishmol, the tshuva b'soif yamav, or Yishmol's name came from the Rabban Yishloidim. There's different reasons why the name Yishmol is given. But Mezev Ravina, Maisa b'doig. Now we know Doig was a bad person. He was a rasha. Yet there was a person by the name of Doig ben Yosef, shenichu oviv ben katan imay. I'm not sure if the father left his wife or if he died, but this child was left alone with his mother. And the mother loved this child so much that she would measure if the child grew. And if the child grew an inch, she estimated that was a pound. And when they sent it, she gave the amount of this child's weight gain in gold to the Beis HaMikdash. My mother would have went bankrupt. And when the enemy took over and tortured us, she was so poor and so hungry that tavachta she shechted her own child that she loved so much, that she valued so much, and she ate this child. And this is one of the things that Yirmiyah Hanavi cried over and was misabel over, and he says, "In techalna noshim piryam, will a woman eat her own fruit? Oydele tepuchin, her delicious child. Oyved, that it came to the point that a mother ate her own child." But Meshiva Ruach HaKodesh, Ruach HaKodesh answers your complaining to Hashem that Klal Yisrael reached such a terrible situation. By Meres, the Ruach HaKodesh answers, "Im Yerag v'miknas Hashem koyin v'navi." How is it possible that Klal Yisrael on Yom Kippur, on Shabbos, should kill Zechariah HaNavi? That you don't mention. You're complaining about what misfortune befell you, but you brought it upon yourself because of what you did. But Akalban, you see that you named someone Doig, even though Doig was a Russia. Zakimur, that's your kasha. Chazim my solopay. Look what happened to this kid. It didn't turn out too well. So that's not a kasha that you found that they named someone Doig. You see, it didn't really work out too well. Omar Belozer, Sadik Mayatzma. A Sadik, there's a different shot with this. Rashi is Sadik Mayatzma. A Sadik is a Sadik by himself, which means Al Yidei Maisav Niskar L'Toiva, he's remembered by himself because he's a tzaddik. But for Rasha Mechaveroi, but a Rasha Rasha is Afal Yidei Chaver Nishkal Ra. He's usually part of a group of Rishonim that are influenced. And therefore, not only do we remember his Rishas, when we think of him, whenever we think of anybody in his Chaver, we condemn them all, so he's always condemned. Tzaddik Me'atmoi, Dichsev Zeche Tzaddik Levracha in singular form. Rasha Mechaveroi, Dichsev Hashem Risham Yirkav in plural form, he's bunched together with his cohorts. Amar le Ravina lahumer abanam. Tav mesader gadat kamei. Ravina had a rav around him who would explain the gadat gemara. He would explain psukim, and he asked the following question: We know milsud amar ban zecher tzadik levracha. Where did we get this from, zecher tzadik levracha? Amar le, he told Ravina, what type of question is that? Daksiv, it says in the pasuk zecher tzadik levracha. It says it in Mishli. So of course we know it's a Mishli. So, where do you find a makar in the Torah to such a concept? It says in the Torah that when Hashem was contemplating Kivayocho destroying Sidon, he said, "Hashem, Amar, Machas Anim Avram, Asher Ani Isa, can I conceal this from Avram?" And then once the Torah mentions Avram, right away the pasuk segues into Ksiv Avram Hayu Yia Lagai Gadol V'Atzum. Right away it mentions the tzaddik and it gives a bracha to the tzaddik that Avram will have a big nation. Once again, Ravina says, I want to know where you see that in the Torah. It says that he I think it's Loit set up his camp at Sidon. And as soon as it mentions Sidon, it says, so there's a very distinct difference. When Hashem mentions the tzaddik, it's levracha, he gives him a bracha. When it mentions the Rosh Hashanah, it doesn't curse the daim. It just mentions that they're evil, but it doesn't curse them. Omar Belozer, Tzadik Dor Ben Shnei Rishoyim. We're going to mention that shortly a Tzadik who lived amongst Rishoyim, and Rosh is the Rishoyim that we're discussing were the two people, Akav and Izebel, and was able to not learn from their Maisim and on their own bring out godless. But on the other hand, you have a Rosh, Dor Ben Shnei Tzadikim, Velelamad Ben Hasayim. Who are these people? Tzadik Dor Ben Shnei Rishayim V'Lamad Masayim is Avadja Novi. So you see, Vamir, that a person can never blame any of his situation on his surroundings. Every person can overcome his situation and make the best of it, and Kishtaik, he can't be limited. And Rosha Dor Ben Shnei Tzadikim V'Lamad Masayim is Esau. He grew up between Yitzchak and Rivka. He had everything going for him in life, yet he still became ugly. So you see that a person is responsible for his own destiny, and a person can be good or bad, and it's incumbent upon our own selves to make sure we do the right thing. Omar Belozer, Yibrachazm Shustadikim, from the Brach of the Tzaddik, at the Lomit Klala Rishon, you usually find there in the same place that the Torah gives a Klala to Rishon. When we Kalasim Rishon, when the Torah is Makala Rosha, at the Lomit Brach of the Tzaddikim, you find there the Torah gives a Brach of the Tzaddikim. Yibrachazm Shustadikim, at the Lomit Klala Rishon, the Siv, Ki Adatit, Hashem said regarding Avram, I know, Leman Asher Yitzaveh, Esponav, I know Avram Avinu will let his children, will train his children to go into Derech HaTorah, and right after that, the Torah mentions the Gnus of Sidon. On the other side, when the Torah curses Rishoyim, it automatically gives a bracha to Tzadikim. And then after that, it goes right away into Vashem Omer El Avram, Achrei Poredot Me'inoi, and the pasuk continues on. He told Avram that I'm going to give you Eretz Yisrael, to son of Necho, Reimen HaMokam HaShat HaShem, to find a Venegma, V'Kaidma, V'Yomam. Zog to Gemara Vayter, I'm Rabbi Lozer, Afilu B'Shvil Tzadik Echad, Oilam Nivra. Even for one tzaddik alone, it was worthwhile to create the world. Shenemar, Vayar Elikim Esa Or, Kitoiv, Or is singular, V'Toiv El Tzadik. And Toiv is written at Shenemar, Tzadik Kitoiv. So you see that even in singular form, as Or Kitoiv, for that alone, it will be worthwhile to create the world. Amar Vlazo, call him a Shakeach, someone who makes himself forget, which means he focuses on nonsense and doesn't spend time focusing on his learning. Because of that, he forgets, Goyim Belos Levanov, it causes his children to go into Belos, Shenemar Vatishkach Tarius Alekecha, and because of that, Eshkas Panecha, Gamani, I'm also going to forget the children. Rabbo Amar, my reading is in Migdolosai, he will lose his position of prestige. Shenemar, Ki Ato Hadas Ma'asta, you didn't want Das, then Moscha Mikoinli, I'm going to make you miss from being a coin to me, I'm going to remove you. It's actually Machloikis. If this applies to Torah Shavuot Peh, but it's a machlokes if it applies nowadays, where even Torah Shavuot Peh is recorded in Sfarim. There are those who learn it was only then, because if you forget Torah Shavuot Peh, that's it, there's not, you won't have it. But since my ass is printed, could be, we don't have that, this problem. Ein tzaddik nifta min ha'olam, Hashem never takes a tzaddik away from the world, ad shenivra tzaddik kamoisa, until the Ribbono Shel Olam is mashlim the tzaddik's presence in the world by another tzaddik that will be born. Shenema v'zorach Hashemesh v'vah Hashemesh actually kafs Hashem shel Eli. Before Eli died, v'zorach Hashem shel Shmuel haramasi. Shmuel already was rising. Amar b'chi ba'abam ab'yechidam. Ra'a kadosh baruch hu shetzadikim hu atem. He saw that in the entire world, the entire history of the world, there's few tzaddikim, and he wanted to make sure that they'll be evenly spread throughout the generations. Amad v'shoslam v'chol do'av v'edor. He spread them out so that there'll be some tzaddikim in every generation. Shenemar, ki Hashem etzukei eretz, to HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the foundations of the world, v'yoshalem table, and he spread across them inhabitants. Amar b'chiyah bar abba m'abyechon, afilu b'shvil tzaddik echad, ha'olam miskayim. The Torah, the Ribbono Shel Olam will be mekayim the world, even on behalf of one tzaddik. Shenemar v'tzaddik in singular form, yisoid olam. B'chiyah didei amar, v'yachav ha'medivim posik. It is raglei chasid av yishmar. The feet of the Hasidim, he will watch. Frank the Gemara, so that doesn't show singular. Chasidav Tuvim Ashma. It means for multiple tzaddikim, the Ribbono Shel Olam will keep the world going. Amar Nachum B'Yitzchak, Chasidav Ksiv. It doesn't have a yud. The Kri is Chasidav, but the Ksiv is Chasidav, so therefore it even applies to one tzaddik. Now that we introduce this pasuk of Ragla Chasidav Yishmar, the Gemara darshens it as well. Amar B'Chiyah Bar Abba, Amar B'Yechidam. Kivan Shiyotzi Rav Shnoistav Shel Adam. Once a person passes most of his life, so if he hits past 60, and he didn't do any averis, he's on the right path. So that inertia, that momentum keeps him going. He will no longer do averis. And the Mefarshim speak out, that's if he doesn't purposely induce himself to do averis. If he just cruises, he'll be okay. Shenemar ragle chasid of Ishmar, and it's yudashim ragle, not as legs, but as lashloisha regolim, time. So the time of the chasid, he'll watch once he's already halfway there. The Reb Shil Amri, Kivin Shabal Liyadoi, Tvar Avera Parmishrayin Ushniya, if a person repels an Avera twice, Vein Nechayta and doesn't succumb, Shove Nechayta, he won't any longer be Nishal that Avera, again, unless he brings it upon himself. Shenema Ragla Chasid of Yishmar, once he's on the path, he'll be watched. Amar Shlok, Shmai Dechsid, Im Leitzim Hu Yalitz, if you want to go to Leitzim, Hashem won't stop you. Hashem won't help you, but he won't stop you. But someone who wants to be with Anova, he wants to connect himself to Aliyah, there Hashem is Yitnechen, there Hashem helps him by inducing him. So Bolitame, if he wants to be Matam himself, they'll let him. Bolitar, but if he wants to retire himself, the Sinai, so they actually assist him. There was a person who sold neft, which smells bad, and a parsimon, which smells good. They're both available. Bolimdoid neft, when a customer comes to measure for himself in a self-serve store, some knife, the store owner will say, self-serve, you can help yourself, no problem. Why? Because he doesn't want to deal with that smelly product. But when the customer comes to buy a parsimon, they'll say, yeah, I know it's a self-serve store, but I'll be happy to help you, sir. I'm happy to help you. You know why? So I can also benefit from it. So it's the same thing. When a person wants to do a bad thing, Hashem lets him. But when Hashem wants to do a good thing, Hashem helps him. Tanu Rebbe Shmuel, a very mitamtemes libesh shalodim, and a very snips up, plugs up the heart of a person. Shenemar, v'loishitamu behem, v'nitmeisem bam. So even though v'nitmeisem means tamei, but it's written without the aleph, al turki v'nitmeisem, ele v'nitamtam. So you see, when someone's mitamu themselves, it also causes a timtum aleph. Tanu Rebbe, al tatamu behem, v'nitamtam bam. And we dash an adam metama atzmai maat. If a person is metama himself a little bit, metama naisei harbe, they'll be metama him a lot. And this means we just learned a minute ago that if someone wants to do something bad, they let him, but we don't help him. So this is already referring to the next step. Once Hashem let him and he jumped in, the next time around, Hashem is going to even help him continue down his bad path. Milamato. If he's metame himself down here, metame nashim milamayla, it affects his neshama up there. And by oilam hazeh, if he's metame himself by oilam hazeh, metame nashim oilam haboh, it's going to mess him up, loss of love as well. On the flip side, which will end the parak with the good perspective, toner ban viskadish them, make yourself kadosh, and then the yisem kadoshim, you'll be holy. Oilam mekadosh asmai ma'at, if a person is even mekadosh himself a little bit, mekadosh nashim harbe, they mekadosh him a lot, and you find that. If you respond to a tzedakah solicitation and you give money, you could know next week you're going to get 10 solicitations. So you see, it's mamish that way b'mitzias. Milamata mekachinoisim milamayla. If you give even if you give zichron binyamin dollars, they'll find you with your name and they'll ask you for a donation and your name. You think you're going to be free? Another but the mishalachim are also going to come knocking at your door.